Eight individuals were reported dead while one is injured in western Visayas due to the onslaught of Typhoon Odette. Among the casualties are 77-year-old Rodolfo Castro and 72-year-old Virginia Palencia in Cebu Nagguimaras. A tree was uprooted by the strong wind brought by Odette, falling on top of the home of the two elderly. The local government said they called for a preemptive evacuation, but the two individuals refused to evacuate.
Kailan ito yung dalawang matanda ayaw. Mm. So, light material yung bahay. Yung mga anak, tinansfer sila sa kubo habang ginagawa yung kanilang bahay.
Negros Occidental Governor Eugenio Lacson has confirmed 4 casualties reported in the province. Videos of Odette's onslaught circulate in social media showing damaged structures, uprooted trees, flooding, and fallen power lines. In Palawan, several homes were damaged due to strong winds and the main roads in the province are impassable due to torn down trees. Affected residents in Nara, Cuyo, and Agutaya also experienced power outage. Palawan Provincial Administrator Attorney Jay Bulusa reports 2,720 families or over 10,000 individuals are currently in evacuation centers. The agency also mulls starting a vaccination drive for unvaccinated residents.
Nagbigyan ako ng order kanina sa PHO na ensure yung medical health ng mga nasa evacuees at kung pwede ay hindi na kailangan mag-gather ng tao, maturukan na sila kagad ng bakuna yung mga wala pa na na babakunahan.
He also assures health and safety protocols are observed to make sure residents are not only safe from the typhoon but also from COVID-19. Meanwhile, aerial footage of the communities in Siargao Island remains submerged in water as Philippine Coast Guard conducts an aerial survey to further assess the effect of Typhoon Odette. Based on the latest data of the Department of Social Welfare and Development, a total of 121,545 individuals, or 32,690 families, have been evacuated in regions hit by Typhoon Odette. Affected regions include southeastern Luzon, eastern Visayas, northern Mindanao, Davao, and Caraga region. Rescue operations in affected areas continue while the country braces for more devastation due to Typhoon Odette. Aileen Cerudo, UNTV News and Rescue, we serve the people, we give glory to God.